Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to take a little bit of time and look at the different starters that you may find on your ATV, side-by-side, or motorcycle. And we're going to test each one just here on the teardown bench using just a regular battery, set of jumper cables, and this little test lead. Now the one in the center is what you're going to find on most of your utility type machines, and it has everything incorporated into one assembly. What you're looking at is the starter solenoid, starter motor, and then it has a bendix gear that is driven into the starting gear, which is typically on your flywheel. Now the next variation on that, it actually separates the starter motor from the starter solenoid, but it still has the bendix that's going to interlock in that gear that's typically on your flywheel. Now the last one still uses a starter solenoid that's separated from the motor itself, but you'll notice that there's not a bendix on this one. This one actually operates through a starter reduction gear and then a one-way clutch. That way it can only turn in one direction, and once it finishes, that clutch is free to spin. So how do you test each one? Well, that's pretty simple to do. We'll start with the standard one, and I'll walk you through it, and then we'll go on to the one with the bendix and then the one without. Now before you start this, make sure that you have a good battery. You can do a voltage test using a meter and just make sure it's north of 12.5 volts. Now make sure there's no open fuel anywhere nearby, because as you're doing this, chances are it may throw a spark. It's just that amount of current trying to travel through each one of these motors. So here's what we're looking at. That this lead here actually goes directly into the motor and through the windings. There is no negative because the body itself is the negative side of the motor. Now this side is typically where your starter wire is coming from the battery. And this little guy right here is the trigger that's coming from your ignition switch or your push button that causes the solenoid to engage the motor, turns the motor, and then engages that bendix that you'll see down here at the bottom. You'll actually see that gear drop down and turn, and then when you release the starter, it pulls back up. You can actually test the starter separate from the starter solenoid, and let me show you how to do that. Go ahead and carry your ground to your body. Go ahead and connect our negative to the battery. And now keep in mind, this is live now, so don't let it touch the framework of the starter itself, otherwise that's a direct short. What we're gonna do is go directly to the starter solenoid positive, and you should hear it click. When we engage this, it's actually gonna thrust the bendix gear down, and that'll tell you that it's working. Now if we wanna test just the starter motor, go ahead and attach this to the wire that's going directly to the motor windings. Now, when we pass it through, you're just going to hear the motor turn. Now here is how you test them together. Put the positive here. That's going from the battery to the positive post of the starter solenoid. All right, we connect that. Look, nothing happens. Now the way you trigger both is to pick up a positive right here, and all we're going to do is trigger the side of the starter solenoid. When we do that, the starter will spin and the bendix will be driven down as well, so they're both going to happen at the same time. See it? One more time. There you go. We've got our battery disconnected. Now, let's go ahead and take all this apart and we'll put the next one in the vise and walk through it. Now this one basically has the starter motor itself with the bendix, but it does not have the starter solenoid attached to it. Now the one I have on here now is a used starter. Now I don't particularly like the color wire that they used for the positive input. Green is usually associated with ground, but we'll get over that. Let's go ahead, connect our positive. And since there isn't a whole lot of groundwork to attach to, we'll use that as our trigger. So we've got our battery hooked up. And what we're gonna do is just ground the other line. And what you're gonna see is the motor is gonna spin and the bendix is gonna come out. It operates on the same principles as our first one. The only difference is the starter solenoid is located at a different location. Now, to test the starter solenoid, we do it the same way as we tested this one. But instead of having a grounded body, it actually has the positive and negative inside the wiring harness. So to test this one, we only need to get to two wires. We need to ground that green wire, and then we're going to send a trigger, 12 volts, to the yellow with a red stripe. And we were going to do that without touching each one, is we're going to use a couple of leads to get on the back side so we don't run the risk of touching the leads together on the plug side. So that's negative. There's your positive. So we've got our jumper cables hooked up to our smaller test leads because this is going to be a low amperage test. We've got our battery hooked up, but we've got the negative held out to the side. And all you're going to hear is just a click, and that's what we're after. Now what that click sound is representing is that a contactor is coming up, getting pulled into position, essentially connecting this point to this point. Now how do I actually know that's happening? The way we're going to test this is to use a digital multimeter, and we've got it connected to the two posts of the starter solenoid, and you'll notice right now it shows an open circuit. That means that those two points are completely separated from each other. And what we're going to do is use the battery just to trigger the solenoid, and when we do that, it's going to bring up a contactor, you're going to hear it click, and then you're going to see a resistance in between these two posts, somewhere in between 1 and 4 ohms. It depends on how well that contactor makes a connection in there. So we'll just hold it for a couple of seconds, let you see the meter change, and then we'll release it. All right, it sees it, 2.37, and then it releases. Then you can hear it as well. Closed, 1.4, open. And what that is allowing it to do is to take the voltage from your battery side, send it over to your starter. It's that simple. Now let's look at our last starter. All it is comprised of is just your housing, which has the negative built into the body, just like the other two. And then you've got one positive lead that will be going over to a starter solenoid somewhere on the machine, and I've showed you how to test that. So to do a static test on one of these, we simply ground the body, we reach in and we grab that center post, and now when I ground it, it is simply going to spin. It has no bendix because it uses a couple of reduction gears as well as a one-way clutch on most vehicles. All there is to it. Well, there you have it. I've shown you just the basics on how to test each scenario that you're going to find on an ATV, side-by-side, or motorcycle. If you need any parts for your machine, why don't you come see us at Partzilla and we can get you taken care of. If you like what you see and want to see what I'm working on next, why don't you hit that subscribe button, that way you'll be notified. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.